Part of implant dentistry also involves bone grafting. Could you tell us a little bit about what that entails and when you may need to do a bone grafting procedure in conjunction with placing an implant?
Absolutely. So to have a successful implant, you need to have good quality bone surrounding the implant all the way around. So if your jawbone is narrow, and which means that if you put an implant in, you would not have bone surrounding it all the way around, you would need to have a bone graft. And whether you need that bone graft at the time of implant placement or prior to depends on how narrow the jawbone or your ridge is. So if your ridge is very narrow, we need to build bone first. We need to have good sound bone quality in that area to put that implant into. So that means freezing the area, gently opening up the gums. And today, most of the time, we use particulate bone. And we have the option of using bovine bone or human donor bone, cadaver bone. And they each have pros and cons, but you can't reject them. The rate of disease transmission is almost 1 in 8 billion. So it is a very, very safe product. And they're both meant to serve as a scaffold or a matrix into which your own bone grows over time. So basically, these particulate bone grafts, which look like sand particles, are meant to guide the growth of your own bone in a specific pattern or position so that over time, your body replaces these bone particles with its own bone. And the healing from a bone graft, depending on the type of bone that we use, depending on your overall medical health, is usually about 6 months. Right. So we used to take, block bone. We used to do block bone grafts by taking blocks of bone from your chin or from other areas of your jaw or even from your hip. I would say that's done less and less today, purely because the success of particulate bone grafts is so good and because there's no second surgical site. So often when we would do block grafts, taking bone from the chin, you would have discomfort in the chin area, but not so much where I did the bone graft. Nowadays, when I use particulate bone, really you have the area where we did the bone graft, but there's no second surgical site. So there's less downside.